This is the continuation of what we have done so far, right? We have gone through the two programs. The one is command line arguments, right? The command line arguments is this, right? And the pointers where it is required. Do you have any doubt on this? Let's get into pointers first, right? I want the people to discuss on that. Is this okay, this part? Please look into that. When you get an output, okay, I've shown here. This, the value of J, you get it just by using J. But value of address of J, you get it by saying, right, ampersand. Ampersand, when you use this one, it is address, I'm sorry. Ampersand J, when you use it, what is happening? Ampersand J is nothing but, it is the address of J, not the value of J. And when you use J only, when you use J, it refers to value. Is that clear? Similarly here, when I use ampersand A, it is the address of I. When I use I, it is a pointer now, look at that. I is nothing but content of I. What is the content of I? Content of I, you have made a key to contain address of J. That's why 284 you see here. That's what is here. You can pictorially draw some boxes, whatever I've shown, put the values there, some dummy, and then try to visualize it. Then when I refer star I, it refers to the content of the memory pointed by I. Where I is pointing? I is pointing depending on whatever its content. It is this address. This address is nothing but J's address. What is J? This. So, star I refers to 200. So, this is the meaning of the pointer when I use this. So, when you are going for outing, when you are driving a vehicle, you will find that, okay, the milestone saying that one arrow mark, take left turn, 2 kilometer, you get a hotel. What is that pointer? Okay, that pointer display, notice board, the board, whatever it is there, the 5-star hotel, 2 kilometer, right? 5-star hotel, is it that in the board? No, it is there somewhere else, but it contains address of that here. Hope, Aryan, this example, okay, you can understand better.
Yes, sir.
Similarly, now I is containing saying that, look, address of the 5-star hotel. I doesn't contain a 5-star hotel. Got it? In that way, you have to visualize. The floor is open for discussion so that we can go to the next program.
No problem, sir.
That's great. That's great. Right? Now, let's look into our Google class. What is the other program that we have added? Command line. One more. Okay, I'm showing you exec command line arguments. Exec, right? Sixth one I'm doing it. Let's look into that sixth one. I'll open sixth one. Both you have to try. Where is sixth one? Yeah. Look. Here, I'll quickly go through. stdio.h. There are many include files. As and when required, you will understand that and you will put it. Int x, alright. Now, in this program, sixth program, through this program, another program you are going to execute it. And that is possible using execl, right, system call. Execute. Execl, exec, there are many variations are there. I'm using this. Are you getting it? Right. What is the program I'm executing? The entire path of that, including the name of the executable, right? Comma, name of the executable, comma, right? Then null character, okay, this type conversion 0, right, representing, converting that into the character, pointer to character, is a null, right? So this program I'm executing using exec test 113. Test 113. What is test 113? Let's look into that, whether it is there or not. Let's check into that. Right? Test 113. Whether it is there or not, let me check. It is not there at all. Right? So what I'll do is 0 CC. Let's look into one program. Cat 0 test dot C. I have written already one C program. What is that C program does? It prints, this is my first program, this is my first program, that's all. Twice it prints. Fine. I compile this. CC minus O test 113, the executable file name I give it, but which source file? 0 test.c. I compile 0 test.c. 0 test.c. I compile 0 test.c and executable file name is called test 113. I'll create. Now I'll run this. Test 113. I get, this is my first program, this is my first program. But I don't want to run like this. I want to run this program from another program. Here. This test 113, I want to run through the program which you are seeing now on the screen. How can you do that? You can use the system call called EXECL. There are variation, EXEC, EXECLP, like this there are variation. I'm picking one.
Excuse me, sir.
Tell me.
There is some doubt regarding the use of EXECL, sir.
That's what I'm saying. EXECL is used to run another program, run one program from another program.
Okay, sir.
Are you getting it? That's what?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Every program, you have to have a comment at the beginning like this, sir. Author, USN, class and division, problem statement, theory required for that, you have to write it, and then program, and take this printout. Okay. The return value of this, if it is equal to minus 1, then there is an error. Display the error using printf. But professional way of doing is p-error. P-error is another system call which will display system error. We will see that how it will display. Then after displaying error, exit 0. Don't do exit. System, there is a constant, built-in constant called exit failure. There is a built-in constant. Right? Right? You have to do that. Okay, we will tell that. Exit failure, exit success. Right? Now look at that. When you execute this program, another program successfully, okay, this line will not be executed at all because this program will not be there at all. Whatever you are seeing a program on the screen, that is being replaced by a new program called test 113. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now, shall we run this and see? Shall we run this and see? Okay, see here. CC 6 EXEC command line CMD LINE dot C. This is my program. I'll run it. Now I'll run it A dot out. This program will run another program. Okay. Test 113 program it will run. And I'll get output. This is my first program. This is my first program. Look. Another program will be executed. This is my first program. This is my first program. And this is not being printed at all. Why? To run another program, right? This program is replaced by that new program in the memory. So this is use of, right, EXECL. Execute one program from another. But what is that? Why did I say this one? You can pass command line arguments also at this stage. Right? This you can pass command line argument at this stage. Now, if at all you give a wrong one, I'll say dummy. The file doesn't exist. Executable file doesn't exist. Then you get error here. P error, this is the name I have given. In front of that, system will display its own error. See that. See that. I'm compiling. I'm running. Right? Hey, I have not saved. Without the saving, if you compile, this is what happens. Huh? Many times it happens like that. I'll clear all the things. A dot out. Hey, what is that? Oh, dummy is also probably may be there, right? 1 minute. I'll put it, dummy is also there, maybe. I'll put it, right, XXX. Hey, what is this? One minute. Save this. 1 minute. I'll check it. Yeah. Now look at that. Another program will be executed now. After that, UPK step 1. That is a point in my program. There's a point in my program, you know. And the system error is no such file or directory. This is the best way of displaying errors. Don't use printf your own things. This is not a good one. Right? You can use this. Right? P error. Right? For that, you need a standard library. Right? stdlib. How to check that one stdlib is required or unistd, this is required. So for that, you go for the manual. Man p error. It says that one, right? It's there part of stdio.h only. Right? P error. Right? It's a part of that. And this manual will help you to know, right, all details. See, routine p error produces a message on the standard error output describing the last error encountered during a call to a system or library function. Right, this system will provide you the message and use that message. So is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. So like this, you have to try with all the things and check into that. So now I'll put once again, test 113. This is the path. This is the path of that particular file. Now, 1 minute. Right, 113 is there, that's why it is showing it. 113, that's 213. Right, so this is the one thing. Okay, now how to know this path and all, right? See, you can print working directory. If you type it, whatever you get to, this is the complete path. it gives you a complete path. This print working directory. Starting from home, okay, user, desktop, okay, desktop on my own folder, right? Within that, all programs are there. You can copy this and put at the end of that one the name of the executable here. That's what I'll put it here. Got it. Then let's, I want to know more about EXECL. How to do it? Go for the manual, online manual, Unix manual, man, EXECL. You'll get all the details. There are many variations are there. Execute a file. Look at that. The EXEC family of function replaces the current process image with a new process image. That's why these lines are not executed. This is being replaced by the new program. I've written it here. Program test will be loaded into same memory. So previous one will go. Previous one, what is that previous one? Right? This. That's why this message doesn't appear. Got it. Right. Now, you can see what all the different arguments, EXEL, okay, path. Then, what are these things? Let's look into that. EXECL. Let's look into EXECL. What exactly speaks about that? You can refer all these details. Return value is also there. Yeah. Look at that here. 1 minute. The first argument, see here. The first argument by convention should point to the file name associated with the file being executed. The list of arguments must be terminated by a null pointer. Okay? Yes. So the description is given here. Please go through this. Right. So any question at this stage?
No, sir.
Right. Now we will run another program. Let's see, look into that. Similar to this and look into that. See, I got another command line arguments. See here, I'll open this. 7 and 8 together I do it. What is 7? What 7 does is, right, look at that. I execute the another program command line arguments, right, then pass these name as a parameter from this program to the another program. 7 program. So I would like to see both, right? Look at the first one. Command line arguments, where is that? Okay, where is command line arguments? Only command line arguments. The exe file, okay, we have created. We use this instead of giving from the terminal, we give it from another program. So I'll create this. I'll compile cc minus o, right? I'll say command line arguments, this is the name of the executable file, and I'll say fiu.cmd command line argument commands.c. So I'll be creating an executable file called command line arguments, right? I'll run this. I got it. Now command line arguments, right, x comma y comma z through terminal, when I give it will display this. But now what I'll do is from another program I'll run this. What is that? That is a 7 exec. Okay, now look at that. cc 7 exec But before that, let me check that one. Right. Okay, this executable file are given correctly or not, I'll look into that. Okay. So now I will compile this. CC 7 comma exec exec command line dot c. Okay, leave it. They're all warnings. Leave it. Right? We can clear all our things. Now, what I do is a dot out, which is I have created out of this. Okay, I'll run this, and this program will run another program by passing parameter here. You can see it will pass command line arguments through this program only, terminated by null character. Right? See now. So the particular program is executed now. The earlier program, whatever it is there now, for that, but I have passed these arguments from here. I am passing these arguments to this program. Right? This is how I can run it. Is that clear? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. That's good. So I will make all this program available to you. I think today it is sufficient, right? We'll come back to you in the laboratory. In the remaining program, we'll see it for the next 2 weeks. Then when Raghunath Yadav comes back, he will continue. In your lab, I'm associating with you along with Raghunath, right? When is your laboratory? On which date is there?
So Saturday.
Saturday. I mean tomorrow only.
Yes, sir.
Tomorrow at what time?
Yes, sir. Tomorrow? Sir, 10:30. 10:30 to 12:30, sir.
Okay, I'll be taking a class. A remaining program I will explain and I'll make it available in Google class. You can download, try. Today, whatever I told, I wanted each one of you try this and be ready. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Right. This is the kind of an arrangement that we are doing it because Raghunath Advad is suffering from COVID-19. He got admitted to hospital. Okay, hope that he will quickly recover and come back. We wish that, right? Yes. So meanwhile, all this adjustment will do. I'll take care of laboratory, and theory part will be taken care by SM Joshi sir, right? You can talk to SM Joshi sir. Already he is in touch with you and do some okay arrangements. This is the stopgap arrangement. We are doing it. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Right. And for any of the things required from you for this stopgap arrangement, please talk to me for laboratory. Talk to SM Joshi sir for theory. In theory also this is there. Then for data structure, okay, Karur madam is taking. Please get connected with Karur madam. You know Karur madam?
Yes, sir.
Please get connected with her. She'll be taking data structure. Right? Data structure or what? No. For you, no. Okay, it's only Unix, right? Who is taking data structure for you? Who is taking data structure?
Indra.
Oh, in that case, Unix only adjustment for you, not data structure. Sorry. Right. So with that, we come to the end. Any doubts here?
No, sir.
Please try. Get connected to Google class and programs are, I'll make it available. There, you please try. Okay. I'll end the meeting now.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, bye. Tomorrow at 10:30, I'll be taking a laboratory. Please attend all. Right, bye.